afternoon, AHS, and welcome to The Rock. I'm Jillian Wells.
And I'm her husband.
In the fall play, you mean. Maxwell Crable here means to say he's my husband in the fall play.
In the what now?
The fall play.
You've lost me.
The play that our school is putting on in 1 week, called Distracted. The one we're both in, together.
Oh, right! I'm also her husband in the play.
He's only my husband in the play.
For now.
If you're as confused and frightened as I am right now, this next segment made by Colin Smith on the upcoming fall play should clear everything right up. It's 7 a.m. Soon he will be awake. I have to meditate, fast. The way I meditate is to say the St. Francis prayer over and over. I love this prayer.
My name is Jillian Welk. I am a senior and I play Mama.
My name is Maxwell Crable. I'm a senior and I play Dad. I'm her husband. It's great.
I'm Lydia Weddle. I'm a freshman and I play a nurse, the teacher, and a psychotherapist.
My name's Aubrey Weller. I'm a senior and I play the same character as she does.
My name's Danielle Olson. I'm a freshman and my part is Vera, an OCD neighbor.
My name is Ariana Cruz. I'm a junior and I also play Vera.
I'm Shay. I'm a senior and I do the sound effects for the play that you will be seeing.
And I'm Brian Humala. I'm a senior and I'm doing the video for the screens that are gonna be behind the actors.
My son has.
Are you a scientist?
Do I need to be?
Because the truth is, I don't fully understand how it works myself.
So the play is about a mom and a dad who are being told that their son has attention deficit disorder. And it's kind of all through the mother's kind of point of view, almost like her little thought bubbles, kind of how they are dealing with it, the different methods they're trying to handle it, and kind of just what she is going through.
Also, we kiss.
And Max and I kiss.
Yeah.
Just putting this out there, guys, I'm not excited about this.
Hold on, just let me get a CD.
But I got distracted.
It'll be funny.
Wow, what a bright and talented group of people they are. And it's at 7:30 next Thursday.
Yeah, 7:30. And man, are they attractive to boot. Hey, Jillian, you know who else is bright, talented, and attractive?
I'm going to hazard a guess just to humor you and say, you.
Not what I was going for, but thank you very much. The real answer are Running Start students.
Oh, you mean the ones that go to school part or full time at Skagit?
Mm-hmm.
You're right, they are. And what have they been up to all the way over there at Skagit anyways?
I don't know. With any luck, a segment made by Addie Olsen may tell us all about it.
So, no one at Skagit Valley College knows you're a Running Start student. At Skagit Valley College, I'm always treated like an adult.
I really like Running Start. I think it's a really great program. Plus, it's like 2 years free of college, and it's not completely free because you still have to, oh no, this is that, right,
okay, it's okay.
I'm taking an English 101 class, which is combined with this global issues class, and I'm also taking pre-calc.
I'm taking a hybrid of English 101 and global issues, and then I'm taking a ceramics class.
I'm taking a hybrid class. It's like an English and global issues combined. And then I'm also taking an online class, History of Rock and Roll, and that's been really cool.
I really like focusing in classes where everyone kind of comes together. Everyone's always participating, and I just really like how grown up it feels.
You have to put a lot of time. Like, I'm spending, basically when I get home, I spend 2 to 3 hours for each hour of class I'm in.
The downside of Running Start is that you are no longer in high school. You're working with in college, and they're going to treat you as a college student.
They treat you like an adult because they don't know you're Running Start student. They have no idea.
You have to be very well task oriented and very motivated, and you're independent. So you have to act like an adult, and that's sometimes some students find that difficult to make that adjustment.
How do you register for Running Start?
Well, there's a process. You need to apply through the college. You have to meet with your counselor, and there is a form, Running Start form, that they will then evaluate what classes you need. It gives you a head start in with free funding. Basically, it's funding from the state for 2 years of college and get your associate arts degree. So if you want to do a jump start going to a four-year university, you end up getting part of your schooling paid for.
Sherman.
What are your questions?
Sit down.
Boy, I'm glad they're alive and well.
You can say that again. I was afraid they've gone to Running Start was just another excuse my teachers gave me. Like when my parents told me that my dog ran away when I was at camp, or when my pet rabbits went to live on a farm.
Hey, Jillian, you know who else doesn't actually live on a farm?
Okay, I actually have no idea here, so who?
Elliot Hofforth, our premier student magician.
You're right, he probably doesn't live on a farm, but that was an awful transition.
Hey, I worked with what I had, okay?
Really? I just mentioned rabbits. You couldn't have made a joke about pulling rabbits out of a hat or something?
You want to fight?
Roll the segment made by Ryan Foggin.
Hi, my name is Elliot Hofforth, and I'm a professional magician. I started magic when I was about 7 years old. I saw my first magician perform at the Anacortes Public Library, and then again 2 years later at the Lincoln Theater, and it really sparked an interest in me and I wanted to pursue it. I pursued magic because it's like an abstract way to express myself in a way that no one else can, and another way to stick out from the crowd, be different from the other people. I have bookshelves full of books and DVDs, as well as mentors all over the US and the world. I have mentors down in Mexico, Cabo, Mexico, people in Las Vegas, California, all over the world, in Canada, and here in Washington too, who I go to monthly and sometimes yearly to go work with, touch up my act, etc. Each piece in my show has a message of some kind, a storyline, and I think we can all take away something from that. Learn something from that story, like in the newspaper tear. It's telling people, hey, basically, don't pick on other people, be nice to them so that they don't make a stupid decision. Everyone can be different, and everyone has their own way of expressing themselves. When the magician levitates on stage, it has a message that they're saying, hey, we can leave these bonds of everyday life and come and do something extraordinary. So it can motivate people to do something that they're not usually comfortable with, or especially expressing stage presence and things like that.
Help, I submit! Mercy, no more!
Oh, Max, we're back on.
The pain finally ends.
Wow, Elliot sure is talented. Now, I want to be a magician when I grow up.
Hey, Jillian, you know what I want to be when I grow up?
A fireman?
No, Mr. Rongren.
I was close.
Here's 60 seconds with demand.
Welcome to 60 Seconds with the Man.
Yeah. Are we live?
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, Seahawk Nation. Principal Rogren here. It's been a while. It's great to see all of you. Ms. Feist, you know what time it is? Or almost what time it is?
It's time for Tiger Hawk.
Tiger Hawk Challenge. Everybody know what Tiger Hawk Challenge is? Why don't you tell us?
Okay. They're not going to answer us.
Oh, okay.
So, we are having a Spirit Club meeting Wednesday in my classroom after school.
Spirit Club meeting, your classroom after school Wednesday.
Seahawk Dynasty.
Seahawk Dynasty is the theme. Now listen, I'm not competitive, but I'm getting a little fed up losing to the Burlington Edison Tigers.
That's right. We need
to win.
We're going
to rock it this year, all right? So, when is the Tiger Hawk Challenge scheduled?
It's December 13th.
December 13th, Friday?
Friday at Burlington.
At Burlington this year. And what are we going to do?
Rock their house.
Rock their house. Because we're what?
Seahawk Dynasty.
We're Seahawk Dynasty. Anything else?
No. That's it.
Outstanding. Seahawk Nation, it's been a pleasure. We will talk to you all soon. How much time do we got left?
Maxwell, I think it's time for us to say goodbye.
Really? Are there no more segments?
I don't think so.
Darn. Well, I guess you're right. We do have to go. Bye, AHS. It's been a pleasure. And get well soon, Mr. Thompson. Sorry to hear about your ribs. All six of them.
From our rock to yours.
Have a great day.